Hello and welcome to my channel. We are going to the yard today. Come with me.
I got Hardy from a lady who retrains racehorses. I actually inquired about a 16-hand horse, and she said that she had Hardy because I said that I was quite slight and I didn't want anything too big. So she said that she had a 15-hand, which was this one. So I had a little look at this post and looked at this walk. And then I looked at this one with him trotting and cantering. There was also one of him free-schooling over a jump. So I said that I was interested and got her to send me loads of other videos of him being trotted up and mounted, feet picked out and groomed and pitched through his legs, etc. And then I had him sent over. And it's a 4-hour drive for him, so I paid to have him transported, and then he came. And I really wish that I'd vlogged our journey right from day one, but I was just so in the moment and I didn't even think of it. But it would have been nice to have seen every single bit, even him arriving at the yard. So I had him in an isolation stable. So I started working on him straight away to get him out of the stable, give him a leg stretch. I'd watched a little video of retraining racehorses, which said about getting them on the lunge, small circle, no side reins, really helps with their balance. And then this is him enjoying his field time. And then this is him a month later. And I've obviously done all of the, you know, walking into a contact before this point, started to trot, and really just establishing, you know, his rein, you know, what's his better rein, getting him nice and supple, getting a good rhythm, and just getting to know him really, hence I'm still here in the indoor school. These are some stills that I got from those videos, so I was really pleased to see that I look like I have the possibilities of having a little event horse. And I took these pictures of him because he started to just lose all his racing muscle and just looked a bit poor, but it's interesting to see how far we've come. I got him out hacking, as you can see. And then here is him starting to canter a bit more. So I have done lots of, or a little bit of canter previously to this video, because I'm currently sat in my dressage saddle on my bum. But I did use my light seat quite a lot with him, because that's where he was happiest. Little bit further along, and then this is him. So actually we started to obviously work regularly in walk, trot and canter, and the only thing that was starting to happen here is he was really anticipating the canter all the time, so you get like those little hoppy bits where he's just like, can we canter now, so it's trying to get the relaxation and trying not to give in and canter every time that he's asking me. Trying to, just get him to relax and feed down the rein. I was obviously really pleased with this because I hadn't seen him trotting for a little while, and it does look a lot different to the other video. So in my vlogs, what I was hoping to do is just give you a little bit of a insight into what we have been doing, and then from now obviously I'll show you what we are doing. This is my friend having a little jump on it. She's going to look after him while I was away, so she was just having a little pop. And I do sometimes ride him in that field. This was our first trip out in the trailer. Some grass. We just went for a hack from this place where we'd gone to. And then we took a trip to the forest. And as you can see, his body shape is changing quite a lot. He looks so much different there. And then our first arena hire in the dressage boards in preparation for our first dressage test. So here we did an intro and a prelim.
Yeah.
So good. He was just so relaxed. He was so good with the atmosphere,
warming
up with the other horses, the arena, the banners. There were some jumps in the corner, and he was very good. So he was tense, possibly a little rushed at times, but he was actually really, really good for where he is in his training. I think he'd obviously only come out of racing in, he'd last race in October 2021. And you know, this is only June 2022. It's not that long really. It's such a big difference. Even the camera work looks so relaxed. Upwards transitions, not too bad. Downwards transitions, just not so good. Sometimes I just tend to just pull him a little bit rather than allowing him to listen to my seat. This here was a little in-house show that we had, so I really am denied about whether to do it or not. He had never been around these jumps before, but I was just kind of under the impression that he's probably going to get this a lot, where he's going around the course for the first time, and I'll just see how he copes with it really. So well, so I just obviously allowed him to kind of come around at his own speed, and he chose to trot, which was fine with me. Allowed him to do the whole round and trot. Move on to this one. Watch his reaction. Look. Okay, yep, he said go, okay. So the plan is to try and get towards, you know, being weighty. I'd be happy with that. And I definitely think he's got potential. It's just seeing whether he enjoys it really. We'll soon find out if he's, you know, showing me all the signs that he enjoys it. So after this last fence, we go off to the right, ready to have another little hop round. So just have a little walk to absorb everything, and then this is the second round. As you can see, just so much more confident. Just getting his legs organised. Sometimes the legs just go a little bit everywhere when he gets excited. The head will just come up a little bit. This fence up here, it doesn't look it, but it is actually really skinny. So I was really pleased with that. And then this fence, second time round. Pop. Love that. So it didn't eat him the first time. And second time, much better. And as you can see, there's horses on the side there warming up. And he is not napping to them at all. He's not even fussed about what they're doing. He's really concentrating on the job. And he's very new to this job. This isn't something that he would have done before or all the time. So I was so pleased with how he coped. Good, and round to the last. We go round to the left this time, because we are finished and we're gonna head towards the gate. And then we got out a little while later, I think it was even the weekend after, to a little crossbow round again on grass. And then after a little while, we come out and did our first round of uprights. So this is actually only still 40 centimetres, which I know is not very big. But I just really didn't know how I was going to cope with the atmosphere, the timing gates, the fillers and everything, so I was glad that I went small. And I'm not the most confident person in the world, so sometimes I'm doing it more for me than for him. I'm sure if someone else had him, they might be jumping bigger by now, but I'm happy with what we do. And obviously I am doing bigger than this now, actually, but at the time. Round goes on, his confidence is just growing. I've never seen these fences before. And that is one thing that I've really enjoyed about retraining the racehorse, because I've never done it before, is just their willingness to go forward. And with that does also come quite a high energy level, which obviously needs taming with lots of variety and things, so it's not been, you know, plain sailing. There was a time where, you know, I've had to start putting him out in the field overnight because he was getting a little bit bouncy and a little bit fresh, but he came first that day. Now this was a lesson that we had with Lisa Hopkins. She came over and did a training clinic near me. And I was really pleased with how he went this day. It looks just a completely different picture.
Good boy.
Let me see how much longer that stride is. Anyway. Quietly. Then we did our first arena eventing, which was really good fun, and he loved it. So when I first walked this course, I thought, I don't know whether he's going to do these. So I stuck at 50, and he flew around. I was really excited. This was a 3-day camp. We didn't stay at the camp, but we went back every day. So we went for the dressage, went separately for cross country and then show jumping. So this was the start of our dressage test, which he was so much more relaxed this time. We've done a couple of dressage tests in between the last one that you saw and this one. So we've had a little bit more practice, but he's so relaxed, as you can probably tell. Skipped a little bit here, so just getting to the canter bits. And we actually were in first place after the dressage. And then I managed to just go a little bit slow on cross country day, and I had 4 faults on show jumping day. Look at how much relaxed he looks. And then again, a little bit car crashy down his transitions. And then you didn't get to see it on my last round, but he can be a little bit of a fidget on the halt. Less so now, but here he was very fidgety. And then a still from dressage test. And then cross country day.
Oh, well done, Hardy.
And I have my mum with me, and she's not horsey, so excuse the commentary, but it is quite funny.
Oh, well done, Hardy.
Mr. Shiny. So actually we're nearly halfway through the course here. I'm now coming up to fence number 6. A lot of the course you can't really see very well. So this is us coming down to the water. And as you can see, he just stops, has a look. He's assessing the situation.
First time he's done it.
And then he decides that actually, okay, yeah, I can cope with that. And we come out the other side.
Well done.
Which I really did let him, I didn't put any pressure on him. I was using my leg, obviously, but I was just very relaxed. Just wanted him to trust me, really, and that he'll one day just fly straight through and, you know, keep a good, confident canter. But just processing. And this is actually our first ever cross-country course. I never really got to, other than our cross-country fences that we've got at home, I never really managed to get out and practice too much, I must admit. The weather had just been so dry, you know, no rain, so I didn't really manage to get out anywhere.
Hardy.
And then he needs to go through the water again. So we're
used
coming
to be a racehorse.
Now to fence number 11.
So this is the first time he's done anything like this.
And he just needs to stop and assess the situation again. But because he didn't step backwards,
go on, boy.
We didn't get any penalties for this. It was just a look, creep.
Yeah, exactly.
And keep moving, and then pop through.
Well done, Hardy.
And then out we come, and then to the last fence. And there's some stills in a minute where you'll get to see the fences a little bit better.
Can't see you
because you can't see a lot from here. So where my mum was standing is where the entrance to the field is.
Well done.
And again, no napping, which I was really thrilled with. There you go. He just really looks the part. He looks so You look so good, so shiny. And then last day, show jumping day. And he could have done with just having the fences a little bit bigger. And we start with a couple of cross poles, but he was still, he left them up, but he's just not jumping properly because of the height, which we do need to start. We did need to start doing from this point, really. Giving him something to just jump, so he learns to jump next. He's learnt the drills of, you know, the walk, trot, canter, jump, the course, you know, going round a course. And he just now needs to learn to jump and pick up his feet. But one thing that I did really take away from this course, which I was really pleased with, which will be coming up soon, so there he just got himself onto left lead canter over the jump and stays left lead canter here. And then this fence he needs to change to right leg, which he did. And then we come round this corner, and then this fence he needs to change back to left, and there we go. So I was really pleased with that, but then it's just a shame about the last. But there's definitely some, you know, good points to take away from that round. The lead changes and the confidence. And then overall, we came fourth. And then came the day that we would been working towards, which was September, and we were doing our first one day event at Soham and District Pony Club. Haven't got any footage of the dressage, I'm afraid, but these were the show jumps. And then this was the cross country course, and then the cross country jumps. And as you can see, he's just starting to jump proper little jumps now. So this was pretty much like the last thing that we did in 2022. We were due to go to one in the October, but I'd had a little fall in training, which was my fault. The boots that I had on got attached to each other and I had a little stumble. Nothing that he did. And then I just hurt my neck, not badly, but just jolted it and needed a little bit of treatment to get back right again. So I didn't compete the rest of 2022. So it got to October, I was just giving him some downtime really. Had a lovely time over Christmas. So as you can see, confidence again. Probably rode him a bit backwards into this one, but good. This one in here as well, number 10, it has two parts to it. So you have to go over this first part and then hook a left to get to the second part, but the video didn't go on long enough to see it. But that was our first little question. And my friend had filmed this and I didn't actually realise, so I was really pleased when I come back and I'd got this. I was so emotional coming over the line on this day, because I was just so excited to have got through it. And then seventh place. This was our first little outing of 2023. So we'd gone out in the for a little hack again. And then this is our first jumping session of 2023. So as you'll be able to see, it's a little bit hairy. The jumps have crept up a little bit higher, probably a little bit higher than I'd liked, but my friend put them up for me. We were really stuffed for time as well, so I didn't have time to kind of mess around too much, but it was good for me actually, because I just got on with it. And the stills of these rounds are much better than the videos. And then we went for another forest trip down to Little Lodge Farm. So good. It's like nearly being on a cross-country course at times, and really good for their cross-country training. So water here. We did a few cross-country jumps, but we didn't video them. Our latest outing, a show jumping arena hire at Anvil, and it was very soon after the last one that we did. And as you can see, the difference, the confidence. I was so pleased with this and really was really looking forward to our first one day event, which I had coming up, which is why I was out and about.
show my face. Worry about him walking flat out with his head up in the air while I've got my phone out, so I plan to kind of come on and have a little chat with everybody today and just say that we are nearly ready for our first event. He's had a 3-day holiday just now, so we're just hacking today, and then we'll get back to work tomorrow. But he is right ready. We've had a little jump early last week and he was jumping really well. You've probably seen the update. So he's just kind of doing enough to get him in the right place ready for 26, which is not a worry. It's only affiliated and it's only 60 centimetres. But mainly for experience reasons, I'm going 60 centimetres, and I probably wish that I'd gone 70 just to stop him from running too much at the fences because of the height, but I think he'll still back off a little bit and look, especially at the structure.